Hi, we will draw a photorealistic cube using Illustrator. Start a new file, art and illustration, letter, inches, 8.5 by 11, RGB color, high 300 ppi, create. File, place. Choose cube, JPEG, place. Go to the upper left-hand corner, click, and make sure the upper left-hand corner is at 0, 0, and the dimensions are 8.5 by 11. Looks good. Label this photo. Lock the layer. Add a new layer. Label this cube. Add a new layer. Label this shadow. Go to the cube. Deactivate the fill, so there's no fill, only stroke. Press P for the pen tool. Click once at each corner. Coming back, when you see an O, that means you will close the pass. Press A for the direct selection tool. Activate the anchor point, and you can use the arrow key to nudge it left and right to place it precisely. Make sure all corners are very precise. Label this cube. Come to the lower left-hand corner and click Draw. Change this from Draw Normal to Draw Behind. So the next pass will be created below this pass. Press P and come to this corner. Make sure you go outside of the cube. Press A, Direct Selection Tool, and nudge the anchor point so that these edges line up perfectly with the photo. Label this top. Press P again, create another pass for the front. Press A for the direct selection tool, activate this anchor point, and then use the arrow keys to nudge it so that this edge lines up perfectly with the photo. Label this front. It is very important to go outside of the cube. Press P again, and we will create another pass for the right side of the cube. Label this right. So now lock the cube layer and go to the shadow. Press P again from this corner, 1, 2, down to this corner, back, and close the pass. Press A for the direct selection tool. Choose this corner and use the arrow key to nudge it so that the shadow line up perfectly with the photo. Label this shadow. Next, we'll do the shading. Lock the shadow layer, unlock the cube. Click here to choose all of the passes for the cube. Go to Object, Clipping Mask, Make. You can see all of the area that goes outside of the cube is hidden by the clipping pass. So let's go to the top. This layer needs a gradient, so I will click the gradient. Remove the stroke. Press G for the gradient bar. Click and drag from the top down to create a gradient. So for the top color, double click, choose the eyedropper, pick a color from the top of the cube. Go to the second color, double click, choose the eyedropper, pick the color from the photo. Move on to the front. Deactivate the stroke. Go to the fill, choose gradient, give it a vertical gradient by pressing the shift key and drag. So the top color, eyedropper, will choose the top color from the photo. Use the eyedropper, choose the color below. Let's move on to the right side. Make sure that the stroke is removed, go to the fill, click the gradient. For this fill, you need 3 colors. From the photo, you can see 1, 2, and 3 colors are needed. Right here, this is the reflection of the shadow. Drag the gradient bar at an angle. First color, choose this corner. the lower color, choose right here. For the reflection of the shadow, move the cursor close to the color bar, and then the plus sign will appear. Click and add a color. Double click, eyedropper, and then pick this value. I want to show you how important the midpoint is. Move the midpoint down closer to the second color, and you see that this becomes darker. I will move this up and down to line up the reflection of the shadow with the shadow. Next step is that you see right here, there is a slightly darker area. You can use a gradient fill to create this, but I will show you a different method. Press P for the pen tool, click here and create a triangle shape. For the fill, use a solid fill, change the solid fill to black. This is created outside of the clipping group. So move this into the group. Obviously, this is soft and this is sharp. So you will come over here to Appearance, click the fill, add an effect, blur, Gaussian blur. Type in 50, press tab, and you can see the result. That looks pretty good. Okay. It is very strong. So I will go to opacity. Just lower the opacity until it matches the photo really well. Lock the cube layer, unlock the shadow, select the shadow path. This needs a three color gradient, 1, 2, and 3. Remove the stroke, go to the fill, and give it a gradient fill. Press G for the gradient tool, and click and drag this gradient bar approximately at this angle. For the first color, click eyedropper, pick this value. The second color, eyedropper, pick this darker value right here. The third color, eyedropper, pick this value. You can see the midpoint is already very close to the second color. I can fine-tune the gradient by moving the midpoint until it matches the photo really well. Deselect everything, and you can see this is really close to the photo right now. Next, we will round off the corners similar to the photo. Unlock the cube, lock the shadow, click on the cube, press A for the direct selection tool, and you can see each one of the sharp corner has a handle. Click the upper left-hand corner, enlarge this, and I can use the arrow key to nudge this so that it is close to the photo. When you drag the handle, you round off the corner. Let's zoom out. It's a little bit softer, and you can adjust this like so. You can round off several corners at the same time by selecting several anchor points while holding down the Shift key. When you drag one handle, all selected corners are rounded off. Next, we will soften the edges. Choose the top, go to the Appearance, choose the Fill, give it an Effect, Blur, Gaussian Blur. Change this to 7, press Tab to see. That looks really good. Then go to the front. So this edge is still sharp, just go to the front, fill, give it the same Gaussian blur effect. 7, looks good. And that's how you can easily round off the corners. Unlock the shadow, choose shadow, press A for the direct selection tool, activate this corner and round off this corner a little bit. Coming to the appearance, to the fill, give it a Gaussian blur. 7, looks good. Press Z for the zoom, and I will zoom in. Deselect. You see a sharp edge right here. That is the photo showing through. So when I turn off the photo, you see that sharp edge disappear. Zoom out. And of course, that also hides the reference photo as well. So let's start a new layer, move this above the photo, press P for the pen tool, give it a solid color, and choose white. So now the photo of the larger cube is hidden. Deselect everything. Next, I will show you how to add this highlight edge. Choose the top. Currently, there's no stroke. So choose the stroke. Add the white stroke to this. And let me hide this so you can see the white stroke. Go to the appearance, click on the stroke, and give it a Gaussian blur effect. And that softened it. Deselect everything, and you can see a very nice soft highlight edge similar to the photo is created. Let's go to the front. I also need the front, give it a stroke. And then on the stroke, give it a Gaussian blur. 7, okay. Deselect everything, so a little highlight edge is created. Next, let's add some color graphics. Press P for the pen tool. From here, from this corner to this corner, down to here. I will give it a red color. Move this into the clipping group. Then change the blend mode to color. Turn off the stroke. Press A for the direct selection tool and use the arrow key to nudge the anchor point to the location I want. Press P again. I will create another color. So this time, probably halfway. So approximately halfway. Move this into the clipping group. Turn off the stroke. Choose a different color. Move this up. Label this violet. Change the blend mode to color. Change this path to red. Deselect everything. Label this black. Label this white. File, save. Make sure the include linked files is checked when you save. Okay. So this is how you can use Illustrator to create a photorealistic cube.